afternoon, students. How are you? How is your preparation going on? Alright, students. So a lot of you have been asking us to tell tips on how to write the exam. And here we are with a quick video before your exam to take care how do you present your answers properly in the exam. Now guys, before I start with my video, let me tell you a very important thing. First and the most important thing is none of you should take tension in the exam. So when you're writing the papers, keep your head cool so that you can think. Okay, your thinking process starts only when the mind is cool and it's not tensed. Otherwise, you would not have the ability to think, and that's where it would be what? It would be wrong from the exam point of view. Now guys, as soon as you get the answer book, alright, first thing that everyone has to do is this. On each of the page, this margin I think is already there. Draw one more margin on the other hand, that is on the right hand side. Now most of you would ask me why. I'll tell you the reason why. Your answer books are tied together. Okay, so all the answer books of the students sitting there are collected and they're tied together. Just in case while tying, if some part of your books gets spoiled, it should not spoil what is written there. And that's where I recommend all the students to draw margin. Now when I talk about margin, don't draw a big margin, guys. It should be a small margin. This part should be really, really big, because it's not your BCom exam where quantity matters, quality matters, guys. So this margin has to be a very small margin. This has to be a very big piece. So this is the first thing you will do as soon as you get the answer book. Now second thing, as soon as you get the question paper, guys, take the last page of your notebook and make it as a rough paper and just write the key points there. Why? Because as soon as you read the question, the psychology says your mind repeats, okay, your mind recalls whatever is the answer to that question. So just keep writing the key points at the end. Okay, this exercise may take 10 minutes of yours, but this would be very helpful. Why? Because you'll not miss on points, and second, you'll not miss on the quality of the answer, that is sequence. Because in the key points, all the key points are written, you know which to pick first and which to pick later. Now how do I write the answer, guys? So this margin and this margin is not to be used by you. How do I write that this is question number one? So you have to present your this thing, answers in this manner. Answer to question number one A, and then start writing the answers. Should I present my answers point wise? I think yes. But if you're not able to do that, create points in such a manner that it is not even points, but it looks like points. That is, right, keep writing each of the point in different paras or different lines. So that would ensure that automatically point wise it is created. But I would always suggest you to write the answers what? Answers in points. Now, sub question 1A I have answered here. Space is there. Should I write sub question B also here? Answer is yes. Answer to question number 1B. You should write here itself. But if it is a fresh question you are starting, question number 1 is over, question number 2 you want to start, start with a fresh page. Suppose you don't know the answer to question number 1C, leave space, guys. Don't make your book as a puzzle book for the examiner to check, oh, 1A is here, oh, 1B is here, 1C is at the end. So leave the space, later come and write something there. Now once I've told you this, there are few do's that you are supposed to do in the exam. First, make sure that you include section numbers, you include case laws. But only when you know the right section numbers and right case laws. Just in case you don't know the right section and right case laws, do not quote it in the exam. It's better not to quote. But if you're quoting, please highlight. Let's say, write it with a black pen. Or underline it, because you have written case laws, you have written section numbers. Try highlighting them in the exam. One very important thing, guys, quality matters, quantity does not matter here. So this you have to take care. Quality, you have to write to the point. Do not write history, civics, geography there and keep writing lots and lots of stories in that. One more important thing, and the most important thing, 100% paper should be attended by. Do not leave any question, come what, write answers to all the questions which are there. Now let's talk about the types of question, guys. So when I talk about the types of question, okay, there are 4 or 5 types of questions which may come in the exam, but the most difficult type of questions that student feels is comment questions or case study or practical questions. Now let me sort out how to answer the common question. Problem one with common question is they'll write something which would be actually a definition or something, and they'll tell explain or comment. So you have no other content to explain that. Or they'll give a particular statement which would have 3-4 hi-fi words, and you don't know from where to start. Guys, when I talk about comment questions, okay, you have to divide your answer into 3 parts. Introduction, the body of the answer, and the conclusion. Introduction has to have what? What is that topic all about? Suppose, for example, they have asked in company law, lifting of corporate wheel, blah, 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 into quotes, comment. So the question is all about what? Lifting of corporate wheel. Make sure you explain lifting of corporate wheel in para 1. Para 2, divide that particular question that is given to you and write it point wise and explain it point wise, including some case laws if possible. And finally, give conclusion by writing the same thing that has been asked as a question. That's how you answer the common questions. Now, how do I write the case studies, guys? Let's talk about the case study questions. So when the question is asked, divide your answer into 4 paras. Should I write the headings? Yes, you should write the headings. What are the headings to be written? First heading should be provision or section. Where you actually write what? You write the section. Okay, what is the provision? What does the law talk about that particular topic? Now, second is fact of the case. So you should include the summary of the case there in that particular topic. And third, you should write question involved. Should I write these headings, guys? Yes, I should write these headings in the exam. Question involved. Is A liable for the penalty? Question mark. Only one liner question with a question mark. And finally, give your conclusion in this. You should give your conclusion in an interesting manner, guys. Armed with above discussion. In light of above discussion. It can be concluded as. So like this, you should write your answer. Did you get my point? Now there is one more way of writing the case which you should use when you are not confident about the answer. So in that, you divide your answer into 3 paras. Here, 4 paras you have divided the answer. There you will divide it 3 paras. Here, you will use the headings. I will not use headings in my second way of writing the answers. So, 3 ways or 3 paras in which the answer is to be divided. Para 1. Where you write what? You just write about the section or the provision, like how you wrote here, but without heading. Second para would be summary of the case plus linking of the provision with the case. Okay, linking of the provision that you wrote in para 1 with the case, you'll do it in what? In second para itself. And third para would be a conclusion that you will write. Guys, do not panic, study cool. Stay calm, and I am quite sure you'll do very well in your exam. All the very best for your exams. Okay, thank you so much.